Hi and welcome to Watch and Work. Watch and Work is ContiTech's service video series for automotive mechanics. In them, you'll learn how to change timing belts on a wide range of vehicle engines, simply, safely and quickly. The videos show the key working steps for workshop pros. They might take a few minutes, but it's worth staying with them. You'll more than make up this time later on when fitting the new belt and any other necessary components. My name is Stefan Meyer, and in each video I'll show you a different vehicle engine, so let's take a look now at today's subject. Today I've got a best-selling engine for you. We have here a 2009 model Volkswagen from the Jetta with engine code CBDB. The kit we need for this engine is this CT1134WP2 water pump kit, and we also need our toolbox V01. I've already prepared the engine in advance. You still need to set TDC, that's to say, there are three points on the engine that need to be locked. First the crankshaft, then the camshaft and finally the high-pressure fuel injection pump. Care is needed again when it comes to the crankshaft locking tool. There's a mark on the tool and also a mark on the crankshaft sprocket. The two marks have to align. With the camshaft sprocket, ensure that the crown is located at the top. Just remember that the crown always sits on the top of the king. And at about 8 o'clock we have a mark into which you then have to insert a pin. In addition, don't forget the high pressure pump. This has a mark at approximately 11 o'clock into which you insert a pin. You've now locked the timing gear correctly. The next step is to loosen the tensioning pulley nut and release the tension in the belt as a result. The belt is off, so you now can start changing components. When fitting the tensioning pulley, you need to note the correct fitting position. The tensioning pulley has a lug here at the back. This lug has to be inserted correctly into the guard at the back there. Another important point to note, only use the supplied seal with the water pump. Do not use any additional sealing compound paste. The sealing compound paste can be detached, become lodged in the water pump or block the cooling circuit. In addition, only use new coolant and flush the cooling circuit. Before you can fit the new belt, you still have to loosen the camshaft sprocket and the high pressure pump sprocket. Please use a counter hold when you do that. Why is it now important to have loosened these two sprockets? This is the only way you can ensure that the belt is not under tension when you fit it and thus avoid misaligning the high pressure pump later. Then note the correct direction for fitting the belt. Start at the crankshaft and follow the drive clockwise. The water pump sprocket is the last one when fitting.
Jetzt ist wieder Vorsicht geboten.
You need to take care again now. When screwing the stud bolt in, please ensure that you screw it in far enough. What often happens is that the stud bolt protrudes too far by 1 or 1.5 thread turns as a result of soiling, and we then later face the problem that the tensioning pulley does not sit flush against the engine. This would mean shear loads acting here on this stud bolt, because the pulley is not mounted flush against the engine block. The stud bolt could then shear off. When mounting the tensioning pulley, make sure that you hand-tighten it with the nut. On the base plate there is a spring, and this has to be correctly tightened, otherwise it may not be possible to tension the tensioning pulley. If the nut is correctly tightened and the tensioning pulley is mounted on the engine, you'll find it's also possible to move the eccentric here. You now tension the belt via the tensioning pulley eccentric until the setting point on the base plate at the rear aligns with the cutout. You've now correctly tensioned the belt. Before you can turn the engine over, you have to remove the locking tools and tighten the two sprockets using a torque wrench and counter hold. Once you've removed the locking tools and have tightened the two sprockets with the torque wrench, turn the engine over through two revolutions and check the timing gear and tension. Okay, you're almost there. You now just have to complete the engine. Please follow the manufacturer's specifications carefully, especially the torques. Remember, take it gently. Before you let this little babe back on the road, don't forget the quality stamp. Place our change sticker in a clearly visible location in the engine compartment.